póngame la mano arriba. Siga, póngame la mano arriba. Pon la mano arriba. Siga, póngame la mano arriba. Siga, póngame la mano arriba. Pon la mano arriba. Siga, póngame la mano arriba. Siga, póngame la mano arriba. Pon la mano arriba. Siga, póngame la mano arriba. Empezar el show del Trio Inca.
Que entre trompos y caritas bonitas es que la vida se explica por más que saquen la
tica.
Desde la calle de San Martín a Tarima, la letra suprema aquí para que usted repita. Con la mano arriba, siga, póngame la mano arriba. Siga, póngame la mano arriba. Con la mano arriba, siga, póngame la mano arriba. Siga, póngame la mano arriba. Con la mano arriba, siga, póngame la mano arriba. Siga, póngame la mano arriba. Con la mano arriba.
Drain gotta. Drain Gina's bitch ass. Drain Gina's
bitch ass.
Drain Gina.
Bitch ass. Wait, I'm in this one. Fuck Charles. Fuck Charles.
Abandonaría, no sabes cómo quisiera. Esto es todo lo que quería. Date cuenta, mi letra es violenta en ocasiones. Ain't nobody like this, ya no one never be frontin'. When I step my game up, always make this ink cielos. Rapping like we never came up, always here on the real.
So Tonos took us to a spot right there in the street. It was in a parking lot, I mean, right there behind a business, and said he's gonna tag up a CHP Who's Crazy piece right there on the streets. These dudes just actually on the street, nobody cared, and they just tagged up this whole wall, Who's Crazy. I mean, it was great, great artwork, and it was dope. I mean, just to see them do that right there in the middle of the street with nobody even caring.
Yo pinto desde que tengo 13 años. Tengo 25 años ahora, ya casi 26, más o menos unos 13 años pintando. Pero todo bien, siempre enamorado del graffiti, voy desde el colegio, así que no he tenido otra distracción aparte del graffiti que me haga sentir tan vivo. He conocido toda mi familia, todos mis amigos se dedican a esto. No tengo nada más que pueda pedirle al graffiti. Mi vida es el hip hop, mi vida es el graffiti. Yo elegí este camino de vivir solamente de eso, de graffiti, del arte, y bueno, vamos a ir lográndolo. Nosotros sí, yo con mi hermano Tonos tenemos un crew que se llama TMH, The Most Hated. Tenemos otro grupo, otro crew que es más antiguo, que es FUC, Shut the Fuck Up Crew, que ya venimos más o menos desde 2005, con otros hermanos como Terco, Vizque, Andes, que también es un gran amigo nuestro. Pero sí, hay muchos grupos, finalmente nos juntamos todos desde pequeños.
Estoy improvisando, soltándolo así, Isaac Shamar, a.k.a. el Drupy G. Con mis hermanos de Crazy Hood, portando la rima demasiado bien. Yo quiero que toda la gente escuche lo que
sino
estoy
que el cantando. Dinero es un instrumento para comprar cosas, nada más. Pero no puede estar por encima de tu familia, no puede estar por encima de tus hijos, no puede estar por encima de tus amigos, ni por encima del hip hop.
I really, really liked Tonos. I thought he was super genuine, super passionate, especially on the art tip. Just an all-around good dude. He was definitely my favorite guy on the trip.
Tonos was something else, man. I mean, this kid was definitely dedicated. He was dedicated to graffiti and he was dedicated to hip-hop. He had a clothing line, he was a promoter, he was a man that wore many hats.
That dude is mad funny, you know what I'm saying? That's the new homie, like. He's like, yo, whenever you come back to Peru, you know, we got you.
Okay, muchas gracias. Hasta luego. So, the company that we got the driver, the people driving us around, the van service, they just called and they said that they heard that we're going to a very dangerous place and they weren't very comfortable with it, and they said they usually would not allow their vans to go in this place. And they asked me if we were sure we wanted to go and if we had someone that was gonna guide us in there and who was gonna make sure that we were safe in this area. And I told them that we had you know, some people with us, more than one person that was going to guarantee our safety, they expressed that not only are they worried about our safety, but the safety of their van and their and the driver. So they said, look, you know, please make sure that you guys are going to have someone that's going to, you know, protect you guys basically while you're there. So I guess where we're going is real deal.
Las damas. Lima, Perú. Yeah. Soy un MC de la movida peruana. Mi presencia aquí pobre es lo que emana. Por acá hacemos rap y con freestyle sin mucho detalle. Déjame mandarte este mail,
bro. Listo, primo. Te sigo. Te sigo.
At that point, going into the hood, Gael, man, it was crazy. It was weird, man. It reminded me like out of a scene of Belly. It's like I knew something was wrong when we pulled up and I seen the slum, and then a dude comes in the ATV and he got like a $250 pair of sneakers on. I'm like, oh, man, this don't add up.
I think, you know, El Callao, it's a special place, you know? There's a lot of bad things that can happen to people there.
They have the power to fuck with every single person that gets off that plane and wants to go to Lima.
And not everyone is allowed to go there, especially with open arms.
When it comes to hip hop, the heart is usually gonna be the most impoverished places, because that's where hip hop started. It's gonna thrive in these places wherever we go. And people start to tell us about Callao.
Going to Callao was definitely an experience. I mean, you hop out the car, there's 10 to 12 kids running around with guns. I mean, there's no other way to say it. We were deep in the hood.
It was like one way in, you know, no way out type of place. So that already there, I'm like, damn, man, we're like on a dead end. Who knows what's gonna happen here? So we get out, you know, there's mad dudes there playing basketball or something like that.
I was, I'm not gonna front, I was a little nervous because, like I, you know, like everyone else said, we had cameras, we had a lot of stuff with us.
We went there on a mission to meet influential people in their hip hop scene, and these people took care of us.
Salsa was a really nice, well-spoken, polite guy, but you know, walking around with him, you just knew that he was the man in that hood. I mean, his artwork was amazing, and just the general respect he had, we wouldn't have got through that neighborhood without him.
Yo soy de Centenario y yo soy un sicario. Me gusta robar mucho, meter plomo a diario. Los lacras de San Judas, que me chupen la pichula. O si no saco la nueve, yo le parto la cintura. A mí no me entran dudas y yo soy peor que Judas. Si se meten con el faite, yo le hago su escritura. Yo soy pendejo y a mi batería yo no dejo. Yo me fui para el cielo, pero le dejo un consejo. Metan plomo a cualquiera, no lo piensen ni siquiera, porque si estuviera vivo yo lo haría.
Para allá, para allá. Ahí estoy llegando por ahí. Estoy llegando por ahí con una visita para grabar los muros.
La primera vez que yo he escuchado hip hop fue por un amigo. Porque a él le mandaron un cassette. Un cassette de hip hop. Eso fueron las primeras estimulaciones musicales, ¿no? Pero lo que más me llenó a mí fue lo que es el arte. Una revista de graffiti que me enseñaron. Después los primeros grafitis que yo hice, lo hice sin saber, ¿no? Hasta al ver la revista, lo que yo hacía, lo hacía sin saber, que era graffiti, era parte de un elemento de una cultura tan importante como el hip hop. Entonces lo que yo empecé a hacer eran retratos de salseros, ¿no? O sea, yo hice del graffiti salsa. En particular eran los que estaban ya finados, como decimos, muertos. En homenaje se le hacía eso. Y de ahí vino mi nombre, Chapa como Salsa.
There's no doubt we could have easily been in danger, but I feel that when we go somewhere with genuine intentions, people in any language will pick up on that. And our intention was simply to learn about their country through what we had in common, which was hip hop.
El nombre salió por esta guada. Entonces,
Crazy Hoodie.
Crazy Hood. Crazy Hood.
Yeah, man, I'm talking about how crazy it is here, and then, you know, talking about how it came. The name, they asked me why we call up, you know, we call each other, you know, we call it Crazy Hood, and I told him about the hoodies, you know, we hoods, because of all the hoodies. And yeah, bro, look, this is what it is. You see, this is the number day in Peru.
Píntame en la pared.
Yo, good love, man. That's my town now. This is my town, baby. That's my town, bro.
Okay.
Good to see you guys.
Thank you, bro. Thank you.
My family right there, my mother.
All right, cool.
I came for 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
Yeah, 2 weeks. I see my family. I'm married, man. I'm married right now. Yeah, that's my wife right there. Mommy, the people's coming for you, for United States. The whole people right here.
It's always humbling to come across warm, kind people, regardless of their living conditions. Strangers willing to give you the clothes off their backs, while in wealthier societies, people don't even want to look in a stranger's direction.
Nah, it's pretty ill, man. Came to check homie. He's a legendary graffiti writer out here. Gave us basically the hood pass. But you know, he says a lot of really like introspective stuff about hip-hop and how it's allowed him to help people outside the hood come into the hood, and for intercultural stuff to happen, and just for the mere fact that we're here and we don't have any problems, it's all love. You're in another country and you're gonna go into the hood, and everybody's saying it's the hood, and then everybody leading up to us coming here was saying, I don't think you should go there. And these are people within the community, within the hip-hop community, people that know the area. So of course, it was a little nerve-wracking. It's just exactly like the theme that we're trying to come with coming home, and what we're trying to find in these different countries, and what we think hip-hop is bringing, and it's the positive side of hip-hop.
Who's crazy? DJ EFN.
Miami to Peru. Let's start this on some next shit. Lord bless this track. I'm about to disrespect it as expected. Never let the pressures of the world influence. Street smart as fuck, cause in school I ran through it. From the ruins of my streets, broadcasting live over beats in the hood, and it ain't all good, see? I got a third world mentality, first world problems. Man, none can solve them, the core motives also. Write me off as a mental case. Started on cassette, now I hustle on your interface. I go nowhere, no fear, we right here. Got some shit you wanna say, players speak that clear. Crazy hoods all air, but we know no lip. Only way that we respond is to split your shit. And I'm inspired off all this rap Peruvian. Not cocaine, it's the hip hop that's moving them. I said I'm inspired off all this rap Peruvian. Not cocaine, it's the hip hop that's moving them.
Esta es la música que nace del corazón. Es algo que no tiene una explicación. Si me preguntan qué es lo que yo pienso hoy, yo te digo que lo mío es el hip hop. Esta es la música que nace del corazón.
De los grupos que hay en Perú, hay unos cuantos que somos cristianos. ¿Entiendes? Nosotros, como Radical People. Y Isaac en sí, Isaac Shamar, que también lo grabaron creo ahora, que también es uno de los pioneros. Entonces, de alguna u otra manera, hemos sido influencia para algunos otros grupos, ¿no?
¿Y ustedes se consideran música cristiana? Porque en los Estados Unidos hay esa, un...
¿Gospel music?
Sí. No, pero raperos gospel.
Claro.
No puede estar en el mundo de hip hop normal.
That's what I'm trying to figure out, if they segregate here, if it's
sí, just, ¿ustedes están en el mismo onda o están en esta onda?
Nosotros no somos raperos cristianos.
Okay.
Somos cristianos que hacemos rap.
One thing I really liked about that studio session, walking in with rapper Juan and La Prince, was that they barely even gave me dap. You know, they made me earn their respect. And I really liked that. I really liked stepping up the challenges. They weren't going to hand me anything just because I was American.
As soon as I walked in the room, the homie rapper Juan was sitting there in the couch, said what up, introduced myself. I told him I was Peruvian from here, and I told him I'm cool with one of his good friends, which is Abron, the guy, you know, we spit, you know, little freestyle in my neighborhood. I was like, yo, let me play you something. And he was like, yeah, go ahead. I played him two beats and he liked both of them. I played on my third one and he was like, yo, I like those two, but let's go with this one. Everybody started, you know, writing, and then homie started writing his verse. The song came out real dope.
No todo es el flow, también es la letra, las ideas que uno implanta.
Y si nos pusiéramos más serios en eso, creo que el hip hop peruano alcanzaría más cosas porque la gente se empeñaría más en escribir mejores cosas, ¿no? Y dar la talla que se merece. Mientras nosotros sigamos pensando que con flow y con eso vamos a llegar lejos, no solamente es el flow es fácil de agarrarlo, chicos. O sea, un poquito de coquito, de mente, nada más.
Si me preguntan qué es lo que yo pienso hoy, yo te digo que lo mío es el bombo y caja, vale más que mil alhajas. Como un open your brain, que aquí no se relaja. Tenemos flow, tenemos estilo, tenemos calle, beats in the hood. Para que no falle, que es lo que quieres tú. This is for Peru, chequealo, vacílalo. Desde Crazy Hood, pa' los homies, pa' la mami. De Lima a Miami, tenemos esa esencia que arrasa con tsunami. Rapper One, así es que me conocen. Ciencia, verdad desde los 12, ya lo busqué, lo sé, mejor tú reconoces que estamos bendecidos, no te equivoques. Esta es la música que nace del corazón, es algo que no tiene una explicación. Si me preguntan qué es lo que yo pienso hoy, yo te digo que lo mío es el hip hop. Esta es la música que nace del corazón, es algo que no tiene una explicación. Si me preguntan qué es lo que yo pienso hoy, yo te digo que lo mío es el hip hop.
Siento que hago el libro que implanto con mi lápiz y papel. Es solo la rima fiel que no me abandona, bro, que esto no se pregona. Eso bien lo sabe la mayoría de la escena. Esto no se frena con mi gozo por ser mamas. Es Cadillac Pink representando a la dama. Esto no se compra ni se vende y por ende esto depende de emociones, sentimientos, pensamientos de un rebelde. Esto es el hip hop y eso no se pierde. Esto es el hip hop y a muchos les arde.
One of the first things I was asking people when we got to Lima was, where are the clubs at? I mean, where are the parties, the hip-hop parties, the hip-hop clubs? I mean, we're coming from Miami. I feel if we're gonna find hip-hop and find key people in their hip-hop scene, it's gonna be at a club. And luckily for us, in Lima at least, Dono was the man. He threw a monthly party.
It just happens once a month there for hip hop. It's, you know, it's not something that's very frequent. And while we were there, it wasn't the time for the party. So these guys were like, you know what? We're gonna throw you a party. We're gonna, you know, have it on the day that we typically don't have it. And we're gonna invite everybody via Facebook.
And I think he put that together like in space like 3 days or something. He promoted it.
Dice H.M.R. a.k.a. el Drupi, haciendo freestyling más rápido que Bruce Lee.
At the party were breakers and MCs from other countries, so we asked a couple of them about the scene overall in South America.
Mi época es video, YouTube, ¿no? O sea, un poco de, más que nada eso, ¿no? Los videos que te llegan, todo eso. En Sudamérica en sí, es a través de, la, de las películas que salieron en el mundo, ¿no? La película de Breaking, la película, los programas de televisión, que no eran muchos en esa época que llegaban, pero algún cassette que otro que llegaba, por ahí la gente más antigua también sabe un poco más de eso, ¿no? Que por ahí uno ve un programa y ve ese baile y copia la película y así nada, practicando entre ellos hasta que una época, calculo que ya pasando los 90, pisando siglo XX, ya empieza el tema de los videos, de la llegada de otros bailarines más de afuera, una mayor comunicación por ese lado. Pero al principio, como todo, video, y gracias a las películas que salieron famosas en el año 84, 85 también, que pasaron por todo el mundo y todos la vieron. Creo que es lo que más llegó a Sudamérica en ese tiempo, para empezar.
Yo veo un futuro muy buenos bailarines, buenos grupos, buenas crew de B-Boys, pero falta todavía pulir acá, cambiar el pensamiento del B-Boy. Mucho choque, demasiada pelea.
So a lot of B-boys, a lot of B-girls. I've seen people spinning on their back, on their ears, neck, all that crazy shit.
The breakdancers were really running things in the club that night. It reminded me of the early 90s, the late 80s, where the B-boys really reigned supreme. You know, if you couldn't breakdance, you really wasn't shit.
It was wall to wall. B-boys, B-girls, rappers, graffiti artists, MCs, even beatboxers, they all came out. It was interesting to see it all unfold, that Donos actually pulled it off.
Hola, ¿qué tal? Yo soy La Prince y soy integrante de Las Damas. Aquí estoy al lado de mi amiga La Sky Sapiens, también integrante de Las Damas.
So it was super dope, man, that he pulled that off within like 3 days' notice.
It was crazy, nasty hip hop bar. Gracias por haber venido. Puta, represent. Y ahí estaba pegando stickers ahí por donde he ido.
Plantas crecen en la tierra. Dos solitos en la
I'm leaving Lima impressed by what I saw and the people we met. We met some incredible people who gave us a crash course in what is Peruvian hip-hop. As excited as I am for the next leg of our trip, I can say I'm leaving Lima wanting to return and learn more about their scene.
We're flying into Cusco. The scenery is just breathtaking. I mean, there's mountains everywhere. We get there, and the majority of the population is indigenous. I mean, these are the descendants of the Incas. This place was breathtakingly beautiful.
Cusco was this amazing place. I mean, the architecture was just out of this world. Cathedrals on every corner of the block. There's just a lot of history, a lot of culture. We saw this amazing parade going on as well. It was just an amazing, amazing place. I got to play soccer with these little kids. I suck at soccer. I've never played soccer in my life. You know? But I walked around and I wanted to get done with the locals and I said, screw it, let me talk to these little 9-year-old kids, see if they can give me a soccer lesson, and they whooped my ass in soccer.
Football Americano.
He sucks.
So we outside chilling. I think me and E is waiting for Charlie to get ready so we can get something to eat.
We're gonna put you in the studio and teach you how to rap like Eminem.
Eminem?
Yeah. So we can do Not Afraid together. We sing it together.
What is your favorite song from Eminem?
Eminem, I'm Not Afraid,
Rap God. Rap God.
Rap God.
He's up to date.
Just Rap God, Rap God.
And he's got these little kids coming up back and forth, trying to sell us stuff. Like, nah, we good. But we met this one little kid, man, and Ben, he just held down a conversation with me, and he was just so funny.
Nice to meet you.
Good kid though, man.
Sorry if I'm moving a little slow. I think I'm suffering from a little altitude sickness. Shortness of breath, massive headaches. And this is coca tea, which they give you for free. It's tea made out of the leaves of coca, which everybody knows they use to make cocaine once it's processed. But here it's all natural. They put it in the tea, normal, they give it to you.
When we get to the Sacred Valley, I mean, this place was even more stunning. It was all a lead up to Machu Picchu.
The Sacred Valley was by far my favorite night of the trip. And it's kind of funny because I didn't even want to go out. I mean, E kept pressuring me, you gotta go out and film. And I had altitude sickness, I'm not gonna front. I just wanted to stay in and I didn't wanna go out. But I finally decided if I'm gonna go out, I'm gonna go out and meet the locals and just see what the Sacred Valley is all about. And I'm really glad I did.
Hola.
Do you know
the rap or the hip hop?
Not much.
Not much, but
Pero conoces pero que sí. Es un música.
Sí, conocemos, sí, pero poco.
Un poco. Es un músico urbano de Estados Unidos.
Claro.
Que la gente está rapeando.
Sí, sí.
Se pum, pum. Sí, ¿no? Sí. Tú sabes, sí.
Sí.
¿Te gusta la música eso o no?
Sí, eso me gusta.
¿Sí?
Sí.
Ok. Señora, ¿tú conoces a una música de Estados Unidos que se llama hip hop?
No, papi, no.
No, es un no, música no. Urbano de Estados Unidos.
No.
So we went out, we went to this bar where they make chicha. It's kind of like moonshine. It's an alcohol that they make straight out of corn. And it was packed with locals that have never heard hip hop. So I figured I'd try to teach them a little something about it.
¿Tú conoces música de hip hop? ¿O de rap?
Rap.
Rap. No. This is chicha. This is alcohol made from corn. Chicha de maíz.
No, okay.
So, yo, I gotta work on my Spanish, man. Like, I told them. I guess I meant to say I can't get drunk. And what I said was,
el señor dice, yo no puedo tomar con borracho.
So, homie was like, yo, we're not drunks, yo. And it really pissed them off. On top of all that, they kicked me out. They didn't want to hear me flow. Like, they were telling me they like rap. I think it was a hustle. I don't know, but they didn't want to hear me flow. I've never been booted off stage in like never.
The Sacred Valley in itself is an experience that I think everybody should at least take the opportunity to do at least one time in their life, because honestly, for me, that's what made the whole trip. There's something about that place, man, it's spiritual, that it was just a beautiful place.
So we had to wake up real early. We left Sacred Valley, we got on a train, went through the mountains.
So you take a train to get to Machu Picchu. It's the only way to get there. And the train tracks end at the bottom of the mountain. Then you gotta take an hour bus ride up the mountain. And basically it's like a cliffhanger. But once you get there, once you get to the entrance of Machu Picchu, it's all worth it.
Machu Picchu was breathtaking. The ability for them people to build those kind of structures that high up on that mountain out of the stones that they just carved out of the side of the mountain, I mean, that's amazing. It's an architectural feat. That's just amazing, man. I mean, that they get all my respect.
Machu Picchu was breathtaking. Really happy that he got to see it. It was beautiful. It lived up to every expectation we had of it.
I feel happy, you know, that I went there for my first time. I felt a good vibe, you know, it was dope.
This is a place you've seen in pictures. You've heard about it. There's movies being made about this place. I don't know, there's just something about this place that kept calling me. These amazing ancient ruins. I mean, you can't even imagine what these people were thinking when they built this, or that they could even build this at all. It was breathtaking. I mean, it was amazing. It was worth everything it took to get there. And I feel that at the end of the day, hip hop is what got me to Machu Picchu. I absolutely found hip hop in Peru, and it was amazing.
We definitely found hip hop in Peru. I mean, I wasn't expecting it to that level, and you know, I was amazed that, you know, that scene is that big over there, and they're that true to the original hip-hop culture that started out here in the States, and they actually carried it.
I definitely found hip-hop in Peru, and I found it in the form that I love to see it, which is in its truest form, its raw essence, the culture. The hip-hop culture lives in Peru. I'm just grateful to be able to go to all these countries and see how big hip-hop has become. You know, it's an American art form that's spread around the world.
And not only did we find hip-hop, but we found genuine people living and doing hip-hop. And that's exactly why I want to keep doing this. Because I feel that every time I go to one of these countries, I'm going to find more of the reason why I started doing hip-hop. And that's exactly what happened in Cuba, and it's exactly what happened in Peru.
I
hace desde el tiempo que yo comencé, que fue hace 6 años, la movida no era tan fuerte, pero ahora se ha crecido bastante y pienso que va a crecer mucho más porque la gente está pero full metiéndole trabajo serio a todo. Entonces sí creo que va a ser una de las potencias fuertes en Latinoamérica de lo que es hip hop.
Se podría decir que está avanzando bastante rápido la cultura hip hop y los grupos están siendo conocidos en el extranjero.
El futuro del hip hop peruano está bueno porque ya las empresas, las marcas, la televisión, las radios se están interesando por el producto peruano. Y algún momento vamos a llegar a ser considerados, o sea, como los otros ritmos.
Lo primero que siempre me ha gustado o me gustaría preguntarle al rapero americano es dónde quedó la esencia. ¿Entiendes? ¿En qué momento se pierde esa esencia, la cultura como tal?
These people inspire me, and they remind me why I do hip hop, and why hip hop is what it is, and where it can go.
Somos una nueva clase de la creatividad y de mucha admiración. Somos patria, patria hermosa. Somos hermanos, somos peruanos. Amémonos entre peruanos y seremos Perú claro de corazón. Que viva nuestra patria, que viva el Perú con honores, señores. Hoy día amaneceré para hacer algo por mi país. Ahí queda.
DJ EFN.
Miami to Peru.
Let's rock this awesome next shit. Lord bless this track, I'm about to disrespect it as expected. Never let the pressures of the world influence. Street smart as fuck, cause in school I ran through it. From the ruins of my streets, broadcasting live over beats in the hood. And it ain't all good, see, I got a third world mentality. First world problems, man, none can solve them. The core motives also write me off as a mental case. Started on cassette, now I hustle on your interface. I go nowhere, no fear, we right here. Got some shit you wanna say, players speak that clear. Crazy hoods on air, but we know no limp.